And it's down to Mel, who has done this before in an eco round. Now with full utility across the board, a Vandal in hand, full HP, spots the first kill, takes zero damage. Sholiana has that Bucky playing the tight angle. Now the retake doesn't feel good with the Bucky, but this close angle feels just as good. That's a right click off the head. Mel going for the 360.
So economy looking little wonky. I've now caught the hang of what's going on with that gravity well. It's to stop Dignitas from pushing in like monkeys like they did on that first round and to add the invulnerable as well. And you can see Mel immediately start capitalizing on that.
They have all the information in the 4v3. Find ourselves in a nice little retake as Cloud9 set up on A.
Listening to that made me feel like I was in an algebra lesson, Tana, please. My brain can't handle that many individualized letters. But that's a really good move from C9. They also utilize the Astral Wall as well. So again, a little bit of a fake there. They do have the spike down. But Emily, again, on this lurk. And she's been so potent previously. If Dignitas can wait, they don't wait for her to get into position. Oh, no.
No, they just jump right on into it. And Mel is ready from that one. Now, at this point, C9 at the very least have netted themselves some extra credits with that spike to come on through. Now the best gun in the game, the Bucky, is online for Mel. It found a kill and almost another. There it is, two kills with the Bucky as Milky was able to cut one down over towards this mid area. Now they have to get that spike defused. The Hunter's Fury is available. Now that Neural Theft gonna grab that information for him. And Annie was probably the last line of defense playing offsite with that Hunter's Fury. Unfortunately not gonna be able to do that now. Mel, nice upgrade from Bucky. Oh my goodness, Mel gets it done.
Mel,
a 4K on the round. Cuts down the Empress and not gonna be long for this world. And Mel coming around the corner, the swing onto Milky, some way, somehow, finding these kills and grabs another. This is exactly why she's the MVP last match. Ooh, vulnerable due to that gravity well. They try and find the kill onto Katie standing right inside. A nano swarm will be A-okay. Just gonna be sent back to the ultimate. We go one for one across the board. And Mel lower on HP, so not really able to take these fights through the smoke.
What?
Able to drop the spike down. Now Diana, we find ourselves in a 2v2, making a 2v1. Diana's done it before. Can she do it again? It's against the rifles. Instead, it's Mel to push Cloud9 ahead 8-7 here. Deep on the flank. Spike is planted, but look at the post plant. This is so interesting. It's all over towards garage, and this is not where you would expect it to be. Katie, the only one on site, but maybe the only one that matters. Curveball comes through, tries and clear it out. Katie finds one. One left click is all it takes. Looks for some more. The right click goes wide, and Lori cuts her down. Divide was used, but Kat just doesn't have a whole lot going for her. Now a 2v2. As Mel picks one up with the nano swarm. They're running out of time. They have to try and send it. Somebody just has to stick it, but the kills come through. They only get it halfway. And Mel goes good for four here to reclaim a lead.
That's correct, because now as they're focused so much on Bench, they had to crossfire from the double box. Now only Clifford by herself as she's able to get Katie in the air. So going with the triple duelist, you have to be fairly aggressive. And you see it, they're trying it, but it's not working out. Mel is doing the same thing. She drops two as a Cypher of all agents, still pushing forward with that Spectre. Gets the first kill onto Dinas, a dink onto a second one. Close range to drop down two to four. The nano swarms all around that spike to cover it down. But speaking about cover, it's Squire covered down from hell through the platform, through the heaven side, and it's Mel and Annie capitalizing on all the kills against Frogs to make it now two rounds in a row.
Look at all the crossfires in hand. Everyone's got somewhere they're looking at. And if you're Frogs right now, you have to manipulate that. You have to come zooming through, be a little bit more aggressive, girls.
Okay, that was beautiful from Mel. She's cracked. Now they're pushing towards mid, and they are working with these flanks. There's another battle that's going to happen, and that's going to ensue towards A main. There has been one here for the Frogs, but Mel still holds the ground.
He may have spotted Alexis up from Crafter, so no one to her here. And Katie just goes all the way around the world kill onto Diana, and Flowerful caught out on the flank. It is the bonus round. It is the SMGs as they look to just take the fight right in the faces. And Panini, the last standing against four. A couple health bars are low, but not enough here.
Is a Hunter's Fury available, though? Oh, but instead of destroying it, they get detained a little bit, but no one has found them. And now the counter lockdown's gonna come down. Not in time to save Panini.
And not in a great spot as the kills just start flooding through. Take the fight right to him. Wall goes down. Spike to follow. They hop up onto Raptors, and Mel just continuing to go ham. Two for her. This time it's Alexis first to fall. Katie to follow. And the Viper's pit to use just to get on the site. But they're already down two members. Fortunately, Mel able to swing it and pick up two.
Talking about a better defender side for CLG Red, you kind of want them to take advantage of those that momentum that is still looking to be found from C9, but this is starting to look a little bit too late. Simple Blades through that because nobody was going to check that corner, was going to check that 50 because they thought that it was covered. And now you're trying to get the Blade Storm for Chobumi on this side for CLG Red and push down. She's only good for one kill. So a slight mistake that turns out to be very costly for CLG Red in that previous round also gives C9 White a 5-round advantage.
Mel's just getting gifted. It's like Christmas in March. Are we even in April yet? I don't even know. Maybe it's an Easter gift.
I want my summer. Let's call it Easter. Easter's good for me.
Unbelievable is what it is. They're going to make a C-long push here, and they want to make it count because they've got short-range weapons to work with. Speaking of short-range weapons, Tactical, one of those! She'll get two for the long, and C9, oh no, they're just making an absolute mess of their opponents here today. That's a match point, baby. I think Katie's about to come up against one. Jet V, Jet and She. The problem, I take that back, ladies and gentlemen. Katie knows exactly what's going on. And now we have that ultimate coming out from the defenders here. C9, White. Can Benita hit the shots that she didn't last time with the Hunter's Fury? No, she doesn't. That's the problem. And of course, she doesn't get as much damage as she needed there. And oh, the showstopper. Jazzykins, you were subbed out from that one. But no, she doesn't make it happen. She can make it happen with bullets instead there.
How does that pay off? And it's actually a half buy that they had, but Naomi tries to stay alive. It doesn't work out. The defuse is coming to come out for Cloud9, and they are the women's champion of the VCT Game Changers, Cloud9 White over CLG Red.